How much free is too much free? I'm here at LACMA, the Los Angeles Museum of Arts, and I'm Shauna Yao, CEO and personal branding strategist at TotalGenius.net, where I help you transform your expertise into a brand story that connects and sells. And today I was approached by a client, a former client, and she was talking about this subject of free. And I wanted to bring this up because I hear this quite often and I see it being misused a lot. And for myself, I had to go through a lot trying to find out what the right amount of free was and why sometimes free worked and sometimes it doesn't. So I did a video on this before, but I wanted to update it a little bit and really dive down into why free sometimes works and why it doesn't. So first of all, I'm just going to tell you what she said. So she was asking me, she just launched a program, and she said, I'm trying to, I'm giving away the farm, and I'm trying to build credibility so that I can sell this program. And so I just knew right off the bat exactly what was going wrong, and that's what I'm going to address here. First of all, though, I want to just define the issue that's going on. So free is essential as a business owner. I mean, as an online business owner especially, you know, we've all heard of the freebie opt-ins. And way back when not a lot of people, or when people were just getting online, you know, freebie opt-ins were like the next big thing. Oh my God, I got something for free. Now, like, everybody's online and everybody's giving away stuff for free. There's free videos, there's freebie opt-ins, and there's free groups, and you know, everyone's giving away free and free's in, you know. It's kind of out of control. And the reality is, there's a big competitor out there, and you know who it is? It's called Google. So everyone's trying to give away free, and the reality is, you know, free has lost its value. It's not that you, the business owner, have lost the value in what you deliver. It's just the fact that information is free. So should you provide free? Yes. You should have a freebie opt-in. You should do free webinars. And you should do free videos. But there's a way that you actually need to approach your free in order to not have it end up devaluing you and your work, and then ending up with a zero bank account. So what, you know, I'm going to go back to what my client was asking me, my former client. She was saying, I'm trying to build credibility. That's the same as, like, I'm trying to prove my value so that people will want to pay me money. Do you see anything wrong with that? You, as the experienced business owner, actually need to be the CEO of your company. There is a different way. So, you know, our brain builds our model of reality by getting rid of things. And then by taking in new information, you know, by our surroundings. This is why people that spend a lot of time on Facebook, the research shows that those people are more depressed, because they haven't built up who they are before they go on there. And so as a business owner, when you're trying to prove your value, you already have value. And in actuality, it's not that you have to prove it. It's that you have to share it. There's a whole different mindset that goes on when you say, I want to share my knowledge, then I need to prove my worth. So I don't know if you see that. I would love it if you would comment if you do. But regardless, you know, I think that this whole entrepreneurship system that's going on has kind of blown out of control, and that new people are coming online, learning from people who've learned about online from online, who've learned about online from online. So you're getting a lot of old, outdated information and taking in bits and pieces of it. And because of it, you lose your sense of identity. And then when you're not making money, you lose your self-worth. And when you lose your self-worth, then you try to prove yourself. And desperation, regardless if you feel desperate, but if you feel like you're trying to prove yourself online, there's nothing to prove. You actually need to share your value. And so, hi Mark, hi Angela. Sharing your value is so different than proving it. Sharing your value means I understand my intelligence. I understand how I help people, and I understand that all information, you know, neuroscience, Harvard classes, they're all free. And because they're free, people can just find them anywhere. So not that you need to compete with neuroscience, but what do you know that you are an expert at? What you are an expert at, you don't need to prove, you need to share. And I like to position it in my own mind as I spend deliberate and focused time sharing my information. When it starts to eat away at my own productivity, my own personal value, my own self-esteem, that's when I say, okay, you know, I think I've pushed my own boundaries of free. And then I need to now go produce and charge. So when you systemize it in your head, how much free you're going to give and what are your, I hate this word, but boundaries, you know, what do you deliberately share? Remember, all information is free, so give away your best stuff. But you're not trying to prove your value. You're trying to add value to other people's lives, and then you go, and then you charge what you're charging. It's kind of like, you know, marketing is free advertising. So, you know, let's just say you were like a store. I mean, you are probably, but let's just say that you were like a retail store. You know, I was a shopping center marketing director, so I'd like to equate things to this. So, you know, when they go and they share their value, hi, Lanice. Yeah, you give them a test drive. So, Lanice is a great example of this. Like, you know, Lanice gives away so much free, you're like, oh my God, like, what's left? And because of it, you know, she has like 25,000 followers on Instagram. Like, she's, you know, like, true and true entrepreneur. When you, like, so let's go back to, like, being a retail store. So when a retail store, you know, when they do, like, fashion shows or, you know, they have their signs out in the mall and, or, you know, they do free makeup demonstrations on people, that's them sharing what they have and what they do best. They're not trying to prove that they can put on makeup on people. They're not trying to prove that they can put clothes together well. Hi, Steve. They're trying to, or they're showing people, you know, wow, this is what you can do with your makeup. Wow, this is how you can dress up an outfit. Do you see the difference? It's not that they have to prove that they're fashionable or that they have makeup. Just like how you, as the entrepreneur, don't need to prove that you're amazing. You just have to share it. So, you know, how you can share this in a deliberate and focused way? You can be like Lanice and Steve, have a podcast. You can share it on Instagram, little bites of information, little testimonials and quotes. You can, you know, do a live video. Hi, Tony. You can do an article. I hate the word blog. So you could do an article, share it on Facebook, rather than writing like what you had for dinner. You could share your opinions because, you know, opinions are a high value. Not, you know, you don't need to. So I see people, great way to word that. Yeah, it's pretty, totally. No, I hate that. There's so many different ways, Lenise, that people say that they can prove it. So I think you missed the beginning of my broadcast where I said somebody asked me or told me that they were giving away the farm trying to build credibility. Your credibility is built. You need to share it with others so they see it. So, you know, this is so important to the way that you think of yourself. So I'm going to equate this to something that is so unrelated to this, but I think it'll help you see. So as I was walking down here to LACMA, I was being followed by this weird homeless woman. And I didn't really notice her. I was just walking down with Harlow and I'm holding my, what do you call that? The tripod. So it looks like a big club stick. But I was just like walking like really casually and I stopped to take a picture of myself because, you know, gotta do the selfies. And then I noticed her and she just stopped like feet away from me, started mimicking me. And then I got really scared. So I crossed the street trying to like run from her, and then she crossed the street too and she tried to follow me. So I, thinking about what I was going to share today, suddenly I instead of crouching smaller, I actually put my shoulders down. I grabbed Harlow tighter because I'm always scared someone's going to steal her. And I grabbed my purse and then I held, I have really, you know, strong muscles. I held my my club tripod tight like a club stick. And you know what happened? She backed off. I didn't do very much different, but I took a power stance rather than like, oh my God, I'm running from you. So, you know, that's very unrelated to business, but what happens is that the way that we think about ourselves subconsciously makes us act in a certain way. I didn't have to say a word. You're right. So it subconsciously makes us act in a certain way, how you hold yourself, how you hold your face, the words that you say, how you position your information, the thoughts that even come out of your head. Because if you're like, if you're scared or you're thinking, I need to prove myself, you're going to say different things and act in a different way than if you're trying to share something. And yeah, it's an energy shift. I'm not like real woo-woo, Elizabeth, but I get it. Like, it's really about positioning yourself. You know, I specialize in positioning. And positioning starts from the inside out. We repel or attract based on our inner power. Yes. So, you know, being and building a strong mind is how you claim your identity before anything else. So, you know, I must preach about active focus meditation every day. And I'm gonna preach it until the cows come home. Because I do it every day. And I was thinking about this morning, you know, I'm going to go a little personal here, so sorry, cover your ears if you don't want to hear things, but you know, I have a super health condition, and so I've had 3 failed surgeries, you know, my thumbs are dislocated, my colon collapsed, and so, you know, I spend a lot of, I spend half my day trying to, you know, I'm incontinent, you know, I wake up and just, it's a mess, but I pull myself together enough to have not, in the past 2 years since my last surgery, missed a day of working out. I go outside, even if I have to go to the bathroom myself outside, I go find a bathroom to clean up, and I do my active focus meditation. And what I realized today is that I have to read that later and respond, Lenise. I can't read this thought, but what I realized is that I've built my mind so strong from doing this every day. And I just recently, just this past week, dug up research about how when you combine your endorphins, so what active focus meditation is you go outside and then do some like run, walk, move your body in some continuous motion where you're breathing fast. It causes endorphins. Then you focus on your success identity, your success goals, not your to-do list, but your highest self. You know, what is your end goal? How, you know, what makes you amazing? What is it that you want to accomplish this year? You know, who do you want to share with? What? And then you listen to your favorite theme song. I have a favorite playlist that builds you up inside. The research I dug up ties in the audio part. When you tie in your endorphins with your thoughts, your positive, highest self thoughts, and you, Lanice, this is active focus meditation though. So when you, the endorphins part is huge. So when you tie in your endorphins with the positive thoughts and the audio, so research now shows that the audio actually is the thing that strengthens and builds new neural pathways in your brain around your confidence. That is groundbreaking, because what I realized since my last surgery, and since I've been doing this every day, and I've had to, you know, go through having to stop and clean myself up, and but what I realized is that I have subconsciously built up such a strong sense of myself that it suddenly just like kicked in, and I don't have to think about it. So, you know, this is about creating success habits. Ooh, I'll have to send you my playlist, Lanice. I think you'll really like it. Eminem is on it, and some other people. But so, you know, success habits starting with what you do in the morning. So, you know, like I know how a lot of people do Hal Elrod's morning routine. I cannot follow someone else's plan. So what I teach, and I'm going to be launching Master Your Money Code next week, but it's a 30-day business breakthrough challenge. And what I teach is a framework. So it's not a system. It's not you have to do these things. It's not, but it's things that you can incorporate and make your own. Because if it's not customized and it's not customized for you, then it's a system that is broken. Because there is not, you know, we are all not the same people. And so there's not one diet, one system, one, and I don't care like what research shows, you know, about this one diet that's like amazing. It's, every body is different. Every cell is different. So what works for somebody may not work for you. It's taking little bits and pieces and putting them all together. That's what creates not just business success, but diet success, life success, brain success. We are all going to have negative thoughts every single day. We beat ourselves up. 80% negative thought, 95% repetitive. You've already beat yourself up today. And then you've also had like, oh my God, I'm amazing moments. That's just human. We're all human. And when, you know, we can appreciate the good, the bad, you know, lean into each and every one of those and find the positive things out of it, that's what success is. Success isn't like, I'm so happy, everything's wonderful. Bruce, you're meditating, manifesting. The stronger, right. But I can't stare at the back of my eyelids. So this is exactly what I'm saying, Lanice, is that when one system doesn't work for everybody. So Tony Robbins, he doesn't meditate. He does what I call active focus meditation. He moves his body and goes and does that. He goes and does that. Don't try to do something just because everybody's doing it. Make it your own. So I created active focus meditation because I tried to do yoga. I tried to do meditating and I thought it was the dumbest thing ever. I have a very like, you know, I need to be active. So I would go and I would like be thinking about my success thoughts, and I noticed that it made a difference in me and my confidence. I call that bulletproofing your confidence. And then, you know, I'm helping one of my clients with her diet, and I'm helping, I don't sell that, but I know so much about holistic health and how different bodies work and how the biology works. And it was affecting her business. She literally, for 20 months, stopped her business because she had accumulated this fear inside of her. And we uncovered it from way back when she was like a child. But then, you know, I had to like dive into what she was eating. Because, you know, when you do certain things in your diet and I know how the body reacts. And she was having these reactions. So we peeled away the layers. And she, on the second day, was like, oh my God, I feel amazing. There's not one system that works. There's not one thing that's wrong. If you can't get to the root, you're just fixing the surface. You know, you can't put, what is it? You can't put a pretty dress on a pig and think that it's going to look cute. This is a baby pig, but I'm just kidding. You know, just like you can't spackle makeup on, you know, a guy and have them look like a girl. It doesn't work. So anyway, Harlow's getting really restless and it's kind of chilly outside. But I just had to share that because I thought that that was something that was really important. And, you know, I really believe that success in business is nothing if you don't have success in life. And success in life starts in your head. Success in life and business. So, you know, apply this to your business, apply this to your life, and enjoy the rest of your night. Because we are... Hi, Harlow. Have a great night, everyone. Come join me at the Genius Collective. And thanks, you guys. I had really smart people on today, and I love you guys. Thank you. Thanks, Elizabeth. Thank you guys for coming. I'll talk to you guys later. And Lanice, I'm going to share my playlist with you. It's so good. Okay, talk to you later. Bye.